Airbags in cars are super important for keeping us safe. They're designed to pop out when there's a crash to protect us from getting hurt really bad. But have you ever wondered at what speed do airbags deploy and why would airbags not deploy? In this short video, we will get you covered with all the answers. We'll talk about how fast they go off and why they might not work sometimes. We'll even look into why there are so many lawsuits about airbags. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. How do airbags work and when do they deploy? You know those cool things called airbags in cars? Well, they're pretty smart when it comes to protecting us in accidents. Let's break it down for you. First off, airbags have sensors all around the car that keep an eye out for potential crashes. These sensors are placed in different locations depending on the airbag. So, if it's a side airbag, it gets info from the side of the car, and if it's a front airbag, it uses sensors in the front. Once these sensors detect a collision, they send the information to the car's computer. If the speed is high enough and the collision meets the criteria, the corresponding airbags will deploy. It's like a super quick decision-making process. Now, let's talk about deployment speeds. When it comes to front airbags, they usually inflate between 10 to 12 miles per hour in a collision with a rigid wall. But if you're wearing your seatbelt, the airbags won't kick in until the vehicle reaches about 16 miles per hour. Seatbelts provide some protection, you see. For side airbags, they deploy at around 8 miles per hour in a narrow object crash, like hitting a pole or a tree. But when it's a more evenly dispersed side impact at around 18 miles per hour, that's when the side airbags come to the rescue. Okay, so how do airbags actually work? They're made of a lightweight material, and when they're activated, they inflate with gas in a blink of an eye. Seriously, it happens in just a fraction of a second. Once fully inflated, the airbag acts as a shield, protecting you from head trauma, spinal cord damage, and lacerations. And did you know there are different types of airbags? There are front airbags for the driver and passenger, side airbags, airbags on the side curtains for rollover accidents, knee airbags to protect your kneecaps, and even inflatable seatbelts that spread out the impact force across your body. Airbags are like our car's superhero sidekicks, ready to deploy in a flash and keep us safe from harm. You know how we said airbags are like superheroes? Well, even superheroes can have their off days. Sometimes, airbags don't deploy when we expect them to. Let's look at some reasons why that might happen. Speed matters. In low-speed collisions, the airbag might not deploy. You see, replacing an airbag can be expensive, so they're designed to only activate in more significant crashes. If your speeds are within the lower ranges mentioned earlier, you can expect the airbag to stay put and not deploy. However, there are exceptions. In some cases, even if you're not moving at all, an object hitting your car at high speed can trigger the airbag deployment. But remember, the engine needs to be running for this to happen. When the car is parked and turned off, the airbags won't deploy. If the airbag hasn't deployed at higher speeds, then we're looking at other possible causes. Nature of the accident. Not all accidents are created equal when it comes to airbag deployment. The location of the impact plays a significant role. For example, if your car's front bumper or a corner gets hit moderately to severely, the front airbags should inflate. The airbag sensors need to be triggered for the airbag to deploy. So, if you're involved in a side collision or rear-end collision, the front airbags might not deploy. On the flip side, during a rollover incident, multiple airbags may deploy due to the activation of various sensors. Passenger airbag switched off. If there are no passengers in the car, the airbag won't deploy. There's no need for extra repair costs when there's no one to protect. Most car models have sensors in the passenger seat that help the front airbag system decide when to deploy. If there's no one present or if the person is smaller, like a child, the airbag won't deploy. Some cars even have a switch for the passenger airbag, and if it's turned off, no deployment will happen. Faulty airbag components. Airbag systems are complex, with many components working together. If any of these components go bad, it can result in airbag problems. Modern vehicles have an airbag light that illuminates when something has gone wrong. It's essential to address this issue promptly and get it fixed to ensure your airbags are in proper working order. So, there you have it. Even though airbags are designed to be reliable safety features, there can still be instances where they don't deploy. Understanding these common causes can help shed some light on why it might happen and ensure you stay informed and safe on the road. Will airbags deploy when the car isn't moving? Here's something you might not know. Airbags can still deploy even if your car isn't in motion. Picture this scenario: you're patiently waiting at a red light when suddenly, a car crashes into you at high speed. In this case, your front airbags will deploy and inflate, as long as the moving car is going fast enough. It's pretty amazing how they can react even when you're not on the move. On the flip side, if the engine isn't running, your airbags won't deploy. So, if you're sitting in a parking lot with the engine off and someone crashes head-on into your car, the airbags won't inflate. It's important to remember that the engine needs to be running for the airbags to do their thing. Now, let's talk about airbag lawsuits. While airbags are designed to protect occupants in a collision, injuries can still happen. When an airbag fails to deploy properly, it can lead to more severe injuries that wouldn't have occurred otherwise. That's why lawyers all over the country often file wrongful death and injury claims against automakers. But here's where it gets even more concerning, when the airbag system itself is flawed and causes more injuries. A prime example of this is the notorious Takata airbag recall. A staggering 67 million airbags were recalled because they had the potential to explode upon deployment. This flaw not only resulted in more severe injuries, but also posed a fatal risk. If your car is part of this recall and hasn't undergone the necessary repairs, it's strongly advised not to drive it. Park your car until it can be fixed by a licensed dealer. Continuing to drive increases your risk of injury, so it's better to stay safe until the issue is resolved. So, whether your car is in motion or stationary, airbags play a crucial role in protecting you during accidents. But when they fail to do so or when there are system flaws, it's important to address these concerns and take appropriate action to ensure your safety on the road. Hope the information was useful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.